Thank you.
Sorry, my dear students, there is a problem of net. So now the net problem has been solved. Again, I'm on the line. You try to understand. Okay, we had started with the topic, okay, what is paragraph? We discussed that is a piece of writing. Simple, it has three parts. Topic sentence and supporting sentences and closing sentences. These all three parts make one paragraph, and all these three parts relate to the topic, relate to the main idea of the paragraph or main theme of the paragraph. Now, as we discussed the paragraph, now I here give you one example of a paragraph in the light of those three parts of a paragraph. I told you that there are three parts of paragraph. Here, I start a paragraph. There are three reasons why Canada is one of the best countries in the world. Now, Canada is one of the best countries in the world. Intentionally, I have not written here the topic of paragraph, so that if I ask you a question, what should be the topic of this paragraph? I hope you can understand that the topic of this paragraph should be the Canada. Means this paragraph tells us something about the country of Canada, because the first sentence is, there are three reasons why Canada is one of the best countries in the world. Now these words clearly tells us that this paragraph is about the country of Canada. So Canada, why is the best countries of the world? So there are three reasons. So those three reasons will prove or will discuss that Canada is the one of the best countries in the world. Now, second means supporting details start. The first, it was the topic sentence. What is the topic sentence? There are three reasons why Canada is one of the best countries in the world. Now, second part starts with, first, Canada has an excellent health care system. Now, this sentence talks about the health system. All Canadians have access to medical services at a reasonable price. Now, look at. Now, these sentences we call body sentences are supporting sentences which support and make body of this paragraph. First sentence, those are the topic sentences. So those topic sentences told us about the topic of the paragraph, which I have not mentioned here, that there must be the topic of this paragraph, Canada, only Canada. Now here this whole paragraph will tell us something about Canada. So that's why the first 10 sentence clearly indicates that why Canada is one of the best countries in the world. Now second part means body details, those support to make the body of this paragraph. Now it starts with, first, Canada has an excellent healthcare system. Now this line tells us that why Canada is the one of best countries in the world, because there is an excellent healthcare system. Every citizen has access to medical services at a reasonable price. So medical services are not so costly, but reasonable price that every citizen can have, easy access to medical services. Now this is one point that Canada is one of the best countries of the world. Now second, Canada has a high standard of education. Now we know well, okay, every country needs health system. Every country needs health facilities and education. Because if people are healthy, they can get education. And education, if quality of education is good in a country, then educational institutions provide all the educated people for every walk of the life, then they join every walk of life of the country. Engineers, if they are good engineers, well-trained professors, if they are well-trained teachers, they can again give the good education to the nation. So health makes the body and education makes the minds. So that's why Canada has paid attention to the high standard of education. Now, students, if I tell you, here the example again, out of this paragraph, that once there was a Prime Minister of Japan, Mr. Suzuki. After Second World War, he became the Prime Minister of Japan. So one people asked him question, I forgot it, mightly he was talking to pressmen. So there was a question to him, okay, after Second World War, Japan was totally destroyed by facing two atomic bombs. Then after atomic bombs, the whole economy, all the system, all the institutions had been abolished, have been destroyed. So now, with the less passage of time, Japan has emerged as a developed country. What is the reason behind it? Mr. Suzuki smiled and asked him that after Second World War, our government paid full attention to the education, means Japanese government established universities, colleges, schools, primary schools, and students were being given high standard of education. So when the nation was highly qualified, highly trained, highly well behaved, and every citizen felt the responsibility of to do their work sincerely and loyalty. So this was the result of a quality education. Education is not only just you see that they are reading books and writing something. No, education is to train the students. Okay, now leave it. We are coming. Okay, second idea was Canada has a high standard of education. That's why it is the best countries in the world. It's true. How can we say that high standard? Because students are taught by well-trained teachers and are encouraged to continue studying at university. And students are taught by well-trained teachers. In some countries, teachers who do not know teachings, how can they teach the students in a proper way? So what will be in the minds of teachers, naturally they will give it to their students. So the students are taught by well-trained teachers, and students are encouraged to continue studying at university. Means, suppose we have 60 students in a class of primary school, then you see that hardly 30 students join high school, and out of 30 students, they join, you see that 20 students at college level, and when college leave the college, the only four or five students join university. But in Canada, students are encouraged to continue their study, and this is why the higher ratio of the students join university. So this was very important reason that it makes Canada is one of the best countries in the world. Finally, Canada's cities are clean and efficiently managed. Canadian cities have many parks and lots of space for the people to live. As a result, now, after having all these things physically and practically done, then what will be the result? Result is that Canada is a desirable place to live, and everybody would like to live in Canada because they know that there is excellent healthcare system, and you see that there is a quality of education and well-trained teachers, good doctors, cleanliness is there, and large space is there, parks are there. So all facilities make Canada one of the best countries in the world. Now this is after this we will discuss the types of, you see that, paragraphs. So then I will tell you that what type of this paragraph is. There are there are four types of paragraph. One is descriptive paragraph. This type of paragraph describes something and shows the reader what a thing or person is like. Now, descriptive word, it clearly describes that this paragraph describes something and shows. What does it show? That what a thing or person is like. When there is a paragraph about a thing or a person or a city, then that paragraph will inform us, will tell us that what the person is like. How is person? How is that thing? And suppose just we about discuss about Canada. So that paragraph describes that how Canada is one of the best cities. It is about Canada. So that is descriptive paragraph, because that paragraph describes all the things through which we come to know that how is Canada, why it is desirable country to live, why do people like to live in Canada. So That paragraph tells us about how Canada is like. So any paragraph when talks about a thing or a person or a city or a place, then that paragraph tells us that how that city is like, or how that thing is like, or how a person is like. Okay, now we come to the words chosen in the description often appeal to the five senses of touch, smell, sound, sight, and taste. These are five senses. So this description is in such a in such a beautiful way, in such a, you see, that captivating way, in such a chanting way, in such an attractive way, that descriptive paragraph touches our senses. Suppose we read paragraph about Canada, you will feel, oh yes, there is, that is a country, that is a great country. How you feel? You feel your senses of feelings, realizing and writing, reading, seeing, all those things with paragraph tell you that how Canada is like. So paragraph, descriptive paragraph is very important paragraph, which talks about anything, which talks about any person, which talk about any place, and describe all the things about that place or person or a country in such a beautiful way, in such a attractive way, in a powerful way, that every man can feel the beauty of Canada. Suppose here I have given example about the second example for the descriptive paragraph. Now, Kinjar lakes in Sindhi, we say Kinjar Dhand, or in Urdu we say Kalri, but here Kinjar Lake, in Sindhi we say Kinjar Dhand. Now this is located in Thatta district of Sindh, the province of Pakistan. If I ask you, what is the topic sentence? Now these two sentences are topic sentences. Why? Because these sentences talk or describe about the Kinjar Lake. So when first word indicates that this paragraph is about Kinjar Lake, because Kinjar Lake is located in Thatta district of Sindh, province of Pakistan. So this is topic sentence which tells us that this paragraph is about Kinjar Lake. Now, supporting sentences start. What are the supporting sentences which make the body of this, you see, their paragraph? Now, this is example, and you can write the name of paragraph above, the Kinjar Lake. Then you go on, then you can write to express or describe something about Kinjar Lake. So now after the topic sentence, we start supporting sentences. Now supporting sentences, as I told you, that supports to make the body of paragraph. Huh? You understand? That supporting sentence means support to make. And without supporting sentences, those sentences make the structure of the, you see, that paragraph. If supporting sentences will not be strong, then the body of that paragraph will be weak and the topic will be not clear. So now supporting sentence starts. It is situated about 36 kilometers from the city of Thatta. Now where is it situated? Where is it situated? It is situated 36 kilometers far from the city of Thatta. You might be knowing about the city of Thatta, and you see that when we reach, you see that Thatta, we go from Karachi to Thatta, and then from Thatta, you see that 36 kilometers we drive and reach the Kinjar Lake. Now, these sentences tell us about the situation of Kinjar Lake. Now, the third point is, it is second largest freshwater lake in Pakistan and an important source of drinking water for Thatta district and Karachi city. Now, second supporting sentences, what are those? Okay, it is the second largest freshwater lake. Why freshwater lake? Because Indus River becomes full of water, then the administration gives water, then the water flows from the Indus River to the, you see the Thatta, towards the Kinjar Lake, because Kinjar Lake is a, you see the largest, Kinjar Lake is a large, you see that lake, so naturally it needs fresh water. So in every summer season, when there is much more water in Indus River, then the required water is given to the Kinjar Lake. So now that Kinjar Lake, where is fresh water, that water is very important, because that is a source of drinking water, not only for Thatta district, but as well as for Karachi city too. Now, number four, Kinjar Lake has been declared a Ramsar site and wildlife sanctuary. Means this is, this you see that lake has been declared as a wildlife, because wildlife means there must be some birds, animals. So this is a visiting place where, so it provides a favorable habitat of winter migratory birds. Okay, now this site has been declared as wildlife sanctuary. It provides a favorable habitat of winter migratory birds. So in winter season, if you would have seen in the television channels, in winter season, limitless birds migrate from different countries to Kinjar Lake, because in winter season the birds of some countries where is much more you see that cold season, that's why they migrate to those places comparatively less cold. So winter migratory birds come to this lake. So again, this is a single paragraph. You see that, which describes the Kinjar Lake, starting with topic sentence, supporting sentences, and closing sentences. So all these three parts of paragraph tells that how Kinjar Lake is like. So this is, you see that descriptive paragraph. Now we come to the second type of paragraph. Now the second type of paragraph, that is narrative paragraph. Narrative means to narrate a story. This paragraph tells a story. So that's why we call it a narrative paragraph. There is a sequence of action, or there's clear beginning, middle, and end of the paragraph. So mostly readers like narrative paragraph because they come to know about the story of anything. You also, when you were children, liked to listen some narrations from your grandmothers or grandfathers. So anyway, I here gave you example of narrative paragraph. A man had a goose. It was not a usual one, as it laid one golden egg every morning. Now this is the first sentence. What does it tell us? The first sentence tells us about the topic sentence. This is a topic sentence and tells us about the topic. And as I told you that intentionally, I have not mentioned here, I have not written the topic of paragraph. When you get this note from YouTube, then you can give the topic, you can write the topic in your exercise copy. Now here, a man had a goose. This first sentence also tells us about this paragraph, that this paragraph is about a goose. It was not usual one, as it laid one golden egg, which it was not a usual goose, but it was unusual or unique type of goose. It laid one golden egg every morning. Every morning he gets one golden egg from the goose. In this way, he collected so many eggs of golden and got the large amount of money and become rich very soon. Naturally, if you are getting golden, you see that eggs every morning, every day, every morning of every day, then you will have golden eggs and you can get much more amount of money every day. So you can accumulate much more money and you can become, you see that very rich in very short space of time. But his wife was not satisfied with this. Now this, you see that man is not thankful to Allah. Whatever we have got so many things from Allah, Allah has given us so many ne'matein hame Allah ne diye hain. Magar hum shukr guzar kitne hum na shukri hote hain ya jald baz hote hain, jhagdal kisam ke log hote hain. Allah kehta hai maine insaan ko paida kiya hai, magar wo na shukr hai. Ab dekho ek aurat ke baad mein ek aurat ka zikr aa raha hai. Ye nahi hai ki sirf aur ladies are only greedy. Men are males are also greedy. Every you see that males are also greedy. Women are also greedy. Not all, but some of the women, some of the men are male people. So now here we talk about his wife, that she was not satisfied. So if one man gets one leg, he said, no, this leg is not enough. Now when one leg is not in your pocket, you had only 1,000, so you wanted one leg in your pocket. When you get the one leg, then I said, no, there must be two legs. So in this way, man is not satisfied. This is why that men of this modern age do not lead a happy life, because they are not satisfied with what they get. And the people of olden times, whatever they got of their labor, whatever they poured their labor, and in resulting they got the money, they remained very much satisfied. Yes, thanks to God, Allah ka shukr hai ki mujhe aaj rozi maine kama li aaj ke din, kal Allah dekh mashallah kya hoga dekha jayega. But nowadays what happens ki now we have cars, buildings, bank balances, so many things. We have become wealthy and health wealthy, but mentally we are not healthy, because we are very, you see that miser, or you see that not satisfied, or greedy persons. So greedy persons cannot lead happy life. So when you see that rich people, when this man gets the golden egg from goose every morning, but his wife was not satisfied. She was very much greedy. Why she was not satisfied? Because she was greedy. Okay, and man can be greedy. Don't mind if you, here is written only wife means female. Not, only females are not greedy, but males are also greedy. She thought the goose has quite in a number of golden eggs, it's warm. Now, what was his thinking? That uske pet mein jo hai na, andar mein jo hai warm, jo hai ande, बनते हैं ना, वहाँ से ही एक रोजाना इसको देती है, तो ये इतने एक यहाँ जमा होंगे ना, तो फिर क्यों ना मैं ये सारे एक 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 टाइम पे ले लूं. तो ये इट वाज हर थिंकिंग. सो दैट्स व्हाई यू सी दैट शी थॉट द गूज हैज क्वाइट ए नंबर ऑफ गोल्डन एग्स इन इट्स होम. Why should we not receive all the eggs at one time? क्यों ना हम सारे eggs एक ही time पे उसके womb से ले लें, कि रोजाना इंतजार करें हम कि भाई कल सुबह होगी फिर हम लेंगे. तो क्यों ना हम सारे eggs एक ही time पे ले लें. So she asked the man to do so. She suggested her husband that we should get all the eggs from its womb at one time. Why should we wait for every day? But the man did not agree with her. So one day the man went out of his house. One day you see that man did not agree with her, and one day the man went out of his house, and his greedy wife brought a sharp knife. उसकी वाइफ ने जो है ना एक बड़ा तेज सा चाकू निकाला, छुरी निकाली, took hold of the goose and cut open its belly. So उस ग्रीडी वाइफ ने क्या किया, वो शार्प नाइफ लेके आई और उसका पकड़ा उसको और उसको काट दिया. काट के उसके अंदर से बेली को खोल दिया. The goose died at once. In resulting, the goose died because she cut the, you see that goose with sharp knife. Thus the foolish woman lost the goose as the prospect of golden eggs. So in getting, you see that all the eggs, she thought that there must be many, many eggs in the womb of, you see that goose. So that's why she killed the, you cut the neck off, you see a goose, and finally they opened the, you see that belly, and she didn't find any egg. हमें ये पता है ना कि कुदरती तौर पर एक एक तो मुर्गी देती है सुबह को, फिर उसी वक्त सिर्फ एक ही एक होता है ना, ये तो नहीं होता है कि एक एक जो है वो उसने दिया है तो फिर 24 आवर्स में दूसरा एक उसके वॉर्म में डेवलप होता है तो दूसरे दिन सुबह को देती है. इधर एक इफ आई टेल यू वन एनेक्टोड, एक लाला था, उसने सब मुर्गियों को बंद किया पिंजरे में और सबको कहा कि सुबह को हर मुर्गी दो अंडे देने चाहिए और जिस मुर्गी ने दो अंडे नहीं दिए उसको मैं उसको मैं काट दूंगा, उसको मार दूंगा. अब मुर्गियां बेचारी परेशान हो गई कि दो अंडे देने, अच्छा नहीं, उसने कहा कि ये मार दूंगा के साथ क्या कहा कि अगर अगर दो अंडे सुबह को नहीं मिले तो मैं सबको मार दूंगा. तो हालांकि ऐसा नहीं है, अगर हमारे वो लाले लाला भाई कोई बैठा हो परेशान हो जाए और माइंड करे तो एक लतीफा है कि उसने कहा कि अगर दो अंडे नहीं देगा कि सुबह को मैं नस्वार खिलाऊंगा आपको. तो जब सुबह को उठा तो देखा कि हर एक मुर्गी ने दो दो अंडे दिए और एक एक मुर्गी ऐसी थी जिसने एक अंडा दिया था. उसने कहा खाना खराब, तुमने एक अंडा दिया है, अभी मैं तुम्हें नस्वार खिलाऊंगा. उसने कहा लाला मुझे मत मारो, मैं मुर्गा हूं, तुम्हारी नस्वार के खौफ से एक अंडा दिया है. तो इस तरह से वो उसने कहा चलो तुम मुर्गा हो, एक अंडा दिया ये भी काफी है. तो ये एक ऐसा लतीफा है. तो वो ग्रीडी औरत भी जो थी ना, वो सोच रही थी कि मैं इस गूस को काट के और जनाब उसके मुंह से पेट से बेली से जो है ना सारे अंडे निकाल दूँ. हालांकि अंडा तो एक ही बनता है 24 आवर्स में. इस तरह उसकी ग्रीड ने जो है ना उसके वो मुर्गी तो मर गई और उसके साथ साथ जो रोजाना अंडा एक देती थी वो भी खत्म हो गई. तो मॉरल इसका है ग्रेस्प ऑल लूज ऑल, जो आधे को छोड़कर सारे के पीछे दौड़ता है तो उसको सारा कुछ तो नहीं मिलता है मगर वो आधा भी नहीं मिलता. अच्छा, अब नाउ दीज टू टाइप्स वी डिस्कस्ड, टू टाइप्स ऑफ पैराग्राफ वी डिस्कस्ड. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस थर्ड पैराग्राफ. आई थिंक यू माइट बी एग्जॉस्टेड और टायर्ड बिकॉज आई नो व्हेन आई यूज्ड टू टेक क्लास सो आफ्टर यू सी दैट 40 minutes or 45 minutes, we used to say, sir, now there must be break. So I know you, but now I think you might be sitting in your rooms very comfortably and listening all these things very clearly. And if you understand and enjoy my lecture, then you might not be tired, but I'm going to first part finish very soon. So after you see the discussing this, third type of paragraph, that is the expository paragraph. Now, expository paragraph, this type of paragraph explains something or provides instruction. Now, provides instruction, yani gives some reasons, gives some instructions, and explains something, this thing is like this, or that thing should be done in that way. So when paragraph in that paragraph is mentioned some instructions to do something according to the requirements of paragraph, that paragraph is called, you see, the expository paragraph. It could also describe a process and move the reader step by step through a method. this type of paragraph often requires research, but it's possible that the writer is able to rely on his or her own knowledge and expertise. For example, I can give one example. There is a captain of an army. 1,000 soldiers are under his, you see, the command. Now they are going to attack enemy's chowki, enemy's border. Now what will he do? He will argumentative. He will talk to the army men, to his soldiers, and he will give the instructions that one group of 200 people should go to this side, and 200 second group of 200 people soldiers should be go to that corner. In this way, 1,000 army men are directed or instructed to take their positions to attack the enemy. Then he will tell them, and when he will indicate them, then they will start firing, or they will start to attack the enemy. So this is just, these are instructions. So when a paragraph is written, when that order or commands are written in a paragraph, that paragraph will be called expository paragraph, because their soldiers may get the instructions to move, how to move to the required places, how to hide themselves, how to attack the enemy, under how to hide themselves in the bushes, and how many people should go in a group. So when that paper, that is called, you see, that a piece of writing in the shape of expository paragraph. So there might be three paragraphs, but every paragraph will be of single theme, single idea. You must remember it. When second paragraph will start, it will start with new idea or with new theme, but will relate to the topic sentence, but will relate to the main command or main order. Okay, now this is, you see, that this needs knowledge, expertise, training. So in the light of, or in the background of the, you see, knowledge, training of the captain, experience of the fighting so many wars, so he can command, he can guide his soldiers to attack properly and get the required results. Now here I have given simple example. This morning at 9 a.m., a school bus collided with a car at the intersection joints and her streets. This is the name of place, the intersection of Jones and Hard Streets. There were no injuries on the school bus. Now, the school bus collided with a car. It was just an accident on the intersection. So, but what was the result of that collision or that accident? That there were no injuries on the school bus. But medical personnel performed checks on each student and the driver before those students were transported to their schools. So naturally, this was the developed countries, and countries system gives much more importance to the school buses or students. If any collision or if any mishap happens, then administration rushes to the spot. You see that ambulances come, along with doctors' teams and doctors' team with medical aides. All people just rush to the spot and they check the students properly, and they found that there were not much more serious the injuries to the students, but all the students were all right. And driver was also checked. So some students were transported to their schools. So in the resulting, they provided another transport bus, and another bus reached their schools. The driver of the car sustained slight non-life-threatening injuries. So naturally, school bus तो वो बड़ी मजबूत होगी ना, और बड़ी होगी कार तो उसके कंपैरिजन में छोटी होगी, तो इसलिए कार ड्राइवर को कुछ सस्टेन्ड कुछ उसको लगे, क्या लगे, स्लाइट, बट कोई खतरे, जिंदगी का खतरा कोई इतना बड़ा खतरे वाली इंजरी उसको नहीं हुई कि वो उसको कोई बड़ा नुकसान हो, मामूली सा जख्मी हुआ. तो ही वॉज ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द लोकल हॉस्पिटल, उसको लोकल हॉस्पिटल में भेजा गया. द एक्सीडेंट इज स्टिल अंडर द इन्वेस्टिगेशन एट दिस टाइम. नाउ दिस इज यू सी दैट एक्सपोजिटरी पैराग्राफ, एंड हियर व्हाट इट डिस्क्राइब्स, इट डिस्क्राइब्स द प्रोसेस एंड मूव द रीडर स्टेप बाय स्टेप थ्रू अ मेथड, एंड यू सी दैट it provides some information about an accident. Okay, my dear, now I end my lecture. Today, inshallah, I'll meet you tomorrow with fourth type of paragraph and with a new topic. So hope we will meet tomorrow. May Allah bless you all. Thank you.